promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Hello and welcome once again to another quick shot review. I am your host Luke and you are the Cheap Shot Nation. And I'm guessing you're expecting another movie review, and so it shall be. This one is a classic murder mystery revolving around the story of Mousetrap by Agatha Christie, a stage play that is still available to go and watch today. And it's not something I've ever seen, but after going to watch this film, I really want to go and watch that stage play. see how they run. Really well written, beautifully shot. Doesn't overwhelm you with the musical scores or anything like that, but it does something that I can't quite put my finger on that not a lot of movies have actually done. It's got the right amount of suspense. It had me fooled. I'm not going to lie. It did have me fooled with the twist. And it was great. So See How They Run has been released this weekend. I believe. Hold on a second. I'll double check that. I'll say this weekend. It has been released. Yeah, it's just 2022. I've been to see it today anyway. It's really, really good. It's got Harris Dickinson in it as Richard Attenborough, of course, the chap who played the main character in the original. Charlie Cooper, Ruth Wilson, Oliver Jackson, Reese Shearsmith, Adrian Brody. Lots of people who perhaps might not necessarily know. So Rose Ronan and Sam Rockwell play the main characters of Constable Stalker and Inspector Stoppard. Like I say, it is your classic murder mystery. And if you want to hear more, please join me in the main part of the video. As we always do, we're going to go through the description of the movie as per Internet Movie Database or IMDb, an app that you can download. And yeah, basically, it's really bloody good. So yeah, I'd suggest you go and watch that. It's not a paid advertisement, that, but it is very, very good. So in the West End in the 1950s, end of the 1950s rather, it's not the end of the 1950s, I believe it was 1953, so this description's already wrong. London in the West End, plans for a movie version of the smash hit play come to an abrupt halt after a pivotal member of the crew is murdered. A murder mystery within a murder mystery. Always good. When world-weary Inspector Stoppard, Sam Rockwell playing that character, and eager rookie Constable Stalker, Sir Rose Ronan, take on the case, the two find themselves thrown into a puzzling whodunit with the glamorously sordid theatre underground investigating a mysterious homicide at their own peril. Like I say, this is really good. They have covered most stuff in the first part of this review before we got the introduction. It is really good, and I actually can't believe that it's got such low scores on IMDb, because it's so good. I mean, it's very British, it's very, very good. It's got everything you'd want from a movie like this. It's entertaining, it's a bit daft in places, it's British. It's everything that you'd expect from that kind of thing, with a bit of a nod and a wink to the audience as well, in the style of Agatha Christie, of course. Director is Tom George, and the writer is Mark Chappelle, which is, yeah, they are absolutely brilliant. And there's odd little bits here and there where, you know, for example, there's a scene, and it's a very mundane scene, really, for anybody else, but I thought it was absolutely brilliant, where the constable is bribing the desk sergeant with biscuits to give him more information. I thought that was absolutely brilliant. Yeah, it's so good. It's fun. It's exciting. Like I say, I was taken in by the by the twist on this one, and it is just brilliant. The main problem with murder mysteries is that once you've seen it once, you know who's done it. But it is really good. I absolutely loved this movie. It's funny. It's brilliant. It's well written. It's shot beautifully. And yeah, like I say, the twist ending at the end was absolutely fantastic. One of the best films I've seen this year, I think. And it seems like, you know, you either get a whodunit right or you get it wrong. I recently watched Death on the Nile on Disney Plus. Again, not a paid advertisement, but it's nowhere near this. And I think it's because, although the story runs alongside the Mousetrap play, it's not fully based on it. It's, yeah, it's difficult to describe. I think, for me, if you like your murder mysteries, if you just like film, this is just wonderful. You know, it's nice to have something different. They could have so easily just said, this is Agatha Christie's Mousetrap film, and just redone it, but they didn't. And, yeah, it was great. The acting was brilliant. It was, yeah, sublime. Absolutely sublime. I would definitely recommend this film. And to say I was a bit weary about going to see it, it just proved me wrong. It just absolutely proved me wrong. It was great. Absolutely fantastic. 100% recommendation to this film. And with that, you have been the Cheap Shot Nation. If you have seen this film, tell us what you think. Always interested in finding out your opinions on films. You know, I'm just a film goer who gives my opinions, but our bread and butter is your opinions as well. And they are just opinions. So if you don't want to go and see this film, don't go and watch it. But if you do like cinema, you do like a good time with the films that you watch, then look no further than See How They Run, released in 2022. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching and or listening, movie fans, and I will see you again next week. Goodbye.